Ah, you've come. Welcome, friends, to my village. My home.
How fare your people?
Good, all things considered. Better than the Inanta, at any rate. They've sent an emissary. I'll take you to her.
We're here to help. Will you tell us what happened?
Aye. It began with a quarrel between the Imperials and the Kalyana.
The Kalyana are another Inanta tribe, the strongest and the most influential. Unlike the Vera, they want no part of our troubles. They swore fealty to the Empire and were content to remain within their borders.
Just so. The Kalyana forsook their pride and the fight and yielded to Garlemald long ago. But then a new commander was sent to hold the Black Bridge. She demanded the Kalyana surrender a hostage, this butcher.
Fordola.
It doesn't make sense, though. The Vera are the ones working with the Resistance. Why would she threaten the Kalyana?
Because she is ignorant, like all Imperials. She knows not the difference between Kalyana and Vera, nor does she care to learn.
I see. All Fordola knew for sure was that the Resistance would come from the west. She reasoned, therefore, that if the Inanta on the east bank turned their coats, she would be trapped. I take it the Kalyana had no choice but to oblige her.
No, they did not. The Imperials left with the Kalyana broodmother's own daughter, Anamika. Long days and nights she looked out on the Black Bridge weeping for her child. Until you came. The broodmother knew at once which way the winds would blow. She and her warriors met with the fleeing Imperials in the road and demanded that her daughter be returned.
Bad idea. Fordola's not the kind to take threats lying down.
You know her well. The butcher turned her blade to Anamika and bade the Kalyana move aside. But the broodmother would not yield.
I know where this is going.
The Kalyana surrounded the Imperials, one of whom, whether out of fear or stupidity, cut the child down. There was naught that could be done.
What madness.
The true madness was yet to come. For in her despair, the Kalyana broodmother cried out for her daughter to be restored to life. She beseeched Sri Lakshmi's intercession.
She summoned a primal then and there?
That she did, if only for an instant. Bereft of courage and honor, the broodmother sought solace in her faith. The Imperials fled in terror at the sight of the goddess, abandoning these lands to the Inanta. Now the Kalyana bid us make pilgrimage to pay proper respects. Yet though we Vera revere Sri Lakshmi as the holiest of the holy, we will not prostrate ourselves before her.
And so you turn to us?
Aye. All who have fought with the Resistance have heard tell of the warrior, the Icon Slayer.
Thank you.
I believe we have heard enough. Inconvenient though the timing may be, if a primal has indeed been summoned, we can scarce afford to ignore it. We must needs discuss how best to resolve this situation.
Thank you.